Good morning, students. So now already in last class discussed this some problems. So today discuss the another problem. So that is three spherical balls of a masses 1 kg and 2 kg and 3 kg. Okay. Now we are placed. So this is called as a at the corners. Okay. And that is the masses 1 kg and 2 kg and 3 kg at the corners of the equilateral triangle. So equilateral triangle, that means so each one 60 degrees, so 60 60 60, got it? So that is the 180, that is the equilateral triangle. Now so find the magnitude of gravitational force. So that is extracted by the 2 kg and 3 kg masses on the 1 kg mass. Okay. Now, so three spherical balls or three masses, that is the 1 kg and 2 kg and 3 kgs. So are placed at the corners of the equilateral triangle. Okay. Now, so to find out the magnitude, that is the force extracted by the 2 kg and 3 kg on 1 kg mass. Okay. Now given, so that is called as a masses is taken. So m1 is equal 1 kg and m2 is equal 2 kg and m3 is equal to 3 kg. Okay. Right. Now, so equilateral triangle, the side is taken 1 meter distance. So 1 meter and 1 meter and 1 meter. That is the distance between the two bodies or two balls. Okay. Now, given that information, so m is equal 1 kg, 2 kg, and 3 kg. So that is the distance is taken. The triangle side of is taken 1 meter. Okay, 1 meter distance or. That is the distance or displacement between the two bodies. Now find the magnitude of the gravitational force. Find the magnitude of the gravitational force extracted by the 2 kg, 3 kg on 1 kg mass. Now, so that is the forces between the two bodies. So now first of all is taken the force between the. So here taken, that is the A, B, C is taken. Okay, so 1 kg and 2 kg. Okay, and so 3 kg and 1 kg. So 2 kg and 3 kg masses on the 1 kg mass. So that is the gravitational force F is equal. So gravitational force F is equal. Now they take the first F1 is equal. Okay, so G M1 into M2 by R square is taken. So now here force F1. Okay. Force F1 and F2 is also taken. So F1, that is the 1 kg and 3 kg. 1 kg, 3 kg. So 1 kg, 3 kg force is taken F1. Okay, that is the gravitational force F1. So F1 is equal according to law G M1 M2 by R square. So that is the G. So is taken G M1 and M2. So M1 is the 1 kg and M2 is the 2 kg by R square. R square is nothing but that is the distance. So the distance is 1 meter. So that is equal 2G. Okay. Now is taken force F2 is also found out. So the F2 force is taken between the 1 kg and 2 kg bodies. Okay, that is F2 force is taken between these two. Okay, now so that is the F2 is equal G M1 M2 by R square. M1 M2 by R square. G M1 means is taken 1 kg and 2 kg. Okay, now is taken, that is the here taken. So for example, this pole is a 3 kg, this is called as a 2 kg is taken. Okay, now we have taken 2, so 2g. Now we have taken 1 and 3, so 1 and 3 is taken 1 and 3 kg by the distance is taken 1 meter. So that is equal 3g. Okay, the force F1 is equal 2g. the force F2 is equal to 3g. Now to find out the magnitude of the gravitational force. So magnitude of resultant gravitational force F is equal to under root of F1 square F2 square 2 F1 F2 cos theta. Okay. Now theta is taken 60 degrees because that is the equilateral triangle. Okay, because equilateral triangle. So cos 60 value is taken. So cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2. Right. Now substituting F1 square. F1 square means 2g square. Okay. So 2g square. F2 square. F2 square means 3g square plus 2. F1. F1 means 2g. F2 means 3g and cos 60. So cos 60 value that taken is 1 by 2. Now is taken under root. That is equal 2g square is nothing but 4g square. Okay. Now 3g square means 9g square. Okay. Now 3 into 2, 6. 6 into 2 or so 2 into 2 or 2g and 3g is taken. That is means g square. So 2 2g 4. So 4 3g 12. So 12g square. Okay. So 1 by 2 is taken. 1 by 2 is means so into 1 by 2. So 2 6 is taken. Under root. So F is equal. That is the resultant force. F is equal. Now we take 4g square, 9g square, 6g square. So 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. So under root of 19g square is equal. So the root is divided. So root 19 and individual is taken g. Okay. So that is under root of 19 into g is called as a resultant external, that is nothing but resultant, so gravitational force, okay? Resultant gravitational force is extracted by the 2 kg and 3 kg masses on the 1 kg mass is taken under root of 19 g, okay? So now first of all is given information m1, m2, m3 and so is there. The distance is taken 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter because equilateral triangle and so each one is taken 60 degrees, that is the angle. Now, so the resultant force F is equal or FR is equal under root of F1 square, F2 square, 2 F1, F2 cos 60. So cos 60 value is taken 1 by 2. Now, so the substituting all those values and we get the final answer under root of 19g. Okay, got it? So now another problem, that is three uniform spheres. We have taken three uniform spheres of masses m and radius is taken r. Okay, so kept in such a way that each touches the other two. Each touches the another two. Okay, so and find the magnitude of gravitational force on any one of the sphere due to the other two. Okay. So find the magnitude of the gravitational force any one of the spheres due to the another two spheres. So now we have taken, that is called as a three uniform spheres each of the mass is m, okay, and radius is r, kept in a such a way that each one is the touches to the another two. Okay, find the gravitational force. Find the gravitational force. Now, so mass of the each, okay, so each sphere, mass of the each sphere, okay, each sphere, that is equal to m1 is equal to m2 is equal to m3 is equal to m. Okay. Now, so that is taken radius. So radius is equal to r. Okay, radius is equal to r. But here taken r plus r, that is called as a 2R is taken radius. Now, so that is the find out the magnitude of the gravitational force. So find the magnitude of the gravitational force. So first of all, is taken N A 2. So F1 is equal G M1 M2 by R square. Okay, so G M1 means M2 means MO, that is called as a 2M. Okay, so MO into M. Okay, M into M, M square. Okay, that is the M square. So by R square means R is equal to 2R. So 2R square means 4R square. Okay, 4R square, F1 is equal. And similarly, F2 is also similar. G M1 M2 by R square. So that is also G M square by 4R square. Because this is called as a uniform spheres. So uniform spheres are placed. So that is the mass is same and radius is same. So the force is extracted is also same. So F1 is equal to some equation and F2 is equal to some equation. So that is equal G M square by 4R square. Okay, now to find out the magnitude of the gravitational force. So magnitude of the gravitational force F is equal under root of F1 square, F2 square to F1, F2 cos theta. So theta means here angle taken is 60 degrees. Okay, or so here taken that is a 60 degrees. Okay, there is an equivalent angle. So that means cos theta is equal or cos 60 is equal 1 by 2 is taken. Now, substituting, so F is equal F1 square, F2 square, that is a F. That means, so similarly, F1 is equal, F2 is equal means F. That means forces are same between any two bodies. So, under root of F square 2F F cos 60. So cos 60 will substitute directly 1 by 2. So 2 R cancel. So remaining equation we get. So F square. That is called as a 3 F square. So under root 3 into F. F square means root 2 and square are cancelled. So remaining under root of 3 into F. So root 3 into F. So F makes G M square by 4R square is called as a, that is called as a resultant force. Okay. So the resultant force under root of 3 G M square by 4R square. Okay, got it. So now we have taken there is a 3 spheres. Okay, 3 spheres are uniform spheres. And so there is a mass is M and radius is R. Now substituting, that is to find out the forces between any two. So forces between any two spheres, that is F1 or F2 or F3. So that is equal G M square by 4R square because that is the uniform spheres. Now, so F is equal under root of F1 square, F2 square to F1, F2 cos theta. Cos 60. So cos 60 value that is 1 by 2. Now F1 is equal mod of F1, mod of F2 is equal F because that is the force between any two bodies, any two spheres is same. In this way, so F is equal under root of 3 F square under root of 3 F. So F value already to find out G M square by 4 R square. Okay, got it. Right. Now, so another problem. So now another problem, that is at a certain height above the earth surface. Okay, so at a certain height of above the earth surface, the acceleration, okay, the acceleration due to gravity is 4% of its value at the surface of the earth. So determine the height. Okay, so determine the height. So that means given that information, so at a certain height above the earth surface, acceleration due to gravity is 4% of its at the surface. Okay. And that means so GH is equal to 4% of G. GH is nothing but so the taken certain height.
So certain height g h is equal to 4% of g. 4% of g. That means so g h is equal to so 4. That means so 4 g by 100 means percentage is equal 100. Okay, 4% means 4 by 100. Now, so according to the definition, so acceleration due to gravity, okay, so g h is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. Okay, so that is acceleration due to gravity. So before that is called as a above the surface of the earth and below the surface of the earth. So that equation, so above the surface of the earth, g h is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. Now, so gh is equal, already we know that given information. So 4g by 100 is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. Okay, so g r cancel. So remaining equation 4 into 25 that. Okay, so now the next equation 1 plus h by r whole square is equal to 25. So 1 plus h by r is equal to under root is nothing but 25 is equal to 5. So 1 plus h by r is equal to 5. 1 plus h by r is equal to 5. So h by r is equal to 5 minus 1. So h by r is equal to 4. That is nothing but, so determine the height h is equal to 4 into r. R is nothing but radius of the earth. So radius of the earth, so that value is so 6.2, that is nothing but we can write the so 6400 kilometers. 6400 kilometers. So multiplication, so we get the final equation, that is a 64 into 4 joule. So 256. So 256,000 kilometers is taken height. Okay, so now is taken gh is equal 4% of g on surface of the earth. So gh is equal percentage means by 100. So 4 by 100 into g. Now, so above the surface of the earth, acceleration due to gravity, so gh is equal to g by 1 plus h by r whole square. Now, so substituting given information, gh is equal 4g by 100, and so comparing and so remaining equation we get, so 1 plus h by r whole square is equal 25, under root of 25 is equal 5, h by r is equal 4. So now to find out the or determine the height, so height h is equal 4 into r. R is nothing but, so that is the radius of the earth. So radius of the earth 6400 kilometers. Okay, 6400 kilometers. So now cross multiplication or multiplication, we get the final equation. So 25,600 kilometers are taken, that is called as a height. Okay, got it. Now, so discuss the another chapter. So that is called as the oscillations on next class. Okay, thank you, students.